Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so today continue with eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Okay, so objective here, you should be able to find the characteristic equation for a square matrix A and then solve the characteristic equation to obtain eigenvalues of A and then find the eigenvectors and a basis for the eigenspace for every eigenvalue of A. Okay, so ada tiga objektif kat sini. Okay, so first introduction here, geometrical relation between vector V and matrix A times vector V. Okay, so matrix A times a vector V, this one will obtain a vector. Okay, so dia akan menghasilkan satu vector. So apa hubungan antara vector V dengan satu vector yang terhasil daripada multiplication of matrix A and vector V. Okay, so let A be an n by n square matrix and V be a column vector in Rn. Usually there is no connection between AV and V. However, if there is a non-zero vector V with the property that V and AV are parallel, okay, selari, then AV is a scalar multiple of V. Okay, so maksudnya matrix A darabkan dengan vector V ni adalah satu scalar multiplication darabkan dengan satu vector V. Okay, so if this one in geometrical view, if the vector is in this form, so dia berbentuk macam ni, so dia tak selari. Okay, so this one no geometrical connection between vector V and A times vector V. Okay, so if the vector V and the vector AV are parallel, okay, so kalau dua-dua ni parallel, sama ada macam ni. Okay, sama ada AV pendek ataupun V panjang, ataupun AV yang panjang dan V yang pendek, ataupun dia bertentangan arah. Okay, asalkan dia selari. So this one, you can say that AV is a scalar multiple of V. Okay, so from this geometrical connection, so it come up with this definition. Let A be an n by n matrix. So the scalar lambda is called the eigenvalue of A if there is a non-zero vector V in Rn that satisfies AV equal to lambda V. Macam inilah. So AV is a scalar multiple of V. Sebab dia selari. So AV ni adalah scalar multiple of vector V. Satu scalar darabkan dengan vector V. Okay, so the vector V is called the eigenvector corresponding to lambda. So lambda ni adalah eigenvalue. Okay, so note here, we will only study the real eigenvalues. Okay, so eigenvalues ni boleh jadi real dan boleh jadi complex number. Tapi dalam syllabus korang hanya belajar real. Okay, real number. And here the eigenvectors V cannot equal to 0 vector because A times 0 vector, it is equal to lambda times by 0 vector, is always true for all values of lambda. Sebab lambda ni, setiap eigenvalue, dia akan ada eigenvector. Tapi kalau V ni sama kosong, so maksudnya setiap eigenvalues ni akan ada eigenvector which is 0 vector. So tu tak betul lah. So that's why the eigenvector cannot equal to 0 vector. And then last, the eigenvalue lambda may have the value of 0. So lambda ni boleh jadi kosong. Okay, so ada yang boleh jadi kosong. Okay. Okay, so example here. Determine whether the vector V1 and V2 are eigenvector for the matrix A is this one and find the corresponding eigenvalues. Okay, so from the definition, matrix A times by V is equal to lambda V. Okay, so kita kena check lah. Matrix A ni darabkan dengan V1, dia berbentuk tak satu lambda darabkan dengan vector V, V1. Okay, so first we check for V1. A V1 is equal to 1, 1, negative 2, 4 times by 1, 2. So it is equal to 1 times by 1, 1 plus 1 times by 2 is 2. And then for the second one, negative 2 times by 1, negative 2 plus 4 times by 2, which is 8. So it is equal to 1 plus 2, which is 3, negative 2 plus 8 is 6. Okay, so comparekan dengan V1, V1 is 1, 2. So 3, 6 actually is equal to 3 times by 1, 2. Betul. So 3 nak 1, 3. Dan 6 ni 3, 3 kali 2. Ataupun korang faktorkan 3, 6. So 3 and 6. So 3 is multiple of 3. 6 also is multiple of 3. Okay, so you can factor out 3. And then 3 is times by 1, 2. So 1, 2 is vector V1. Okay, so this one is equal to 3 times by V1. So therefore, AV1 is equal to 3 times by V1. Okay. So therefore, V1 is the eigenvector for matrix A. So V1 is eigenvectors for matrix A. And then after that, how about V2? So kita tengok V2 pula. So AV2, it is equal to 1, 1, negative 2, 4. V2, which is negative 1, negative 1. Okay, so calculate. So 1 times negative 1, negative 1, plus 1 times negative 1, negative 1. Then negative 2 times by negative 1, positive 2, plus 4 times negative 1, minus 4. Okay, so this one, it is equal to negative 1 plus negative 1, negative 2. 2 plus negative 4 become negative 2. Negative 2, so this one, 2 is multiple of 2. This 2 also multiple of 2. So you can factor out 2. And this one become negative 1, negative 1. Okay. So it is equal to 2 times by V2. So since AV2 is equal to 2V2, so V2 is eigen vectors for matrix A. Okay. So another example. This one for 3 by 3 matrix. Okay, so first determine whether the vector V1, V2 are eigen vector for matrix A and find the corresponding eigen values. Okay, so yang tadi tu, yang ni corresponding eigen values dia adalah 3. So this one corresponding eigen values dia adalah 2. Okay. Okay, so for this one, AV1, so this equal to 0, 1, 2, 0, negative 1, 0, 0, 0, negative 1, times by 3, 0, 0. So this equal to, okay, so 0 times by 3, 0, 1 times by 0, plus 0, then plus 2 times by 0, 0, then 0 times by 3, 0, negative 1 times by 0, plus 0, and then plus 0 times 0, 0. And for the last one, 0 times by 3, 0, plus 0 times by 0, 0, plus negative 1 times by 0 is 0. So it is equal to 0, 0, 0. Then compare with V1. Okay, so this one, it is actually equal to 0 times by 3, 0, 0. Okay, so V, this one is not 0 vector, but the eigenvalue here is 0. Okay, so tadi dalam note tadi, saya bagi tahu apa? Eigenvector tak boleh sama dengan 0 vector, but eigenvalue can be equal to 0. Okay, so eigenvalue dia boleh jadi sama dengan 0. Okay, so since AV1 is equal to 0 V1, so V1 is eigenvector for matrix A with corresponding eigenvalue equal to 0. Okay. Then for the V2, okay, so we check A times by V2. It is equal to 0, 1, 2, 0, negative 1, 0, 0, 0, negative 1. Times by 2, 0, negative 1. So it is equal to 0 times by 2, 0, plus 1 times by 0 is 1, plus 2 times by negative 1 is negative 2. Then 0 times by 2, 0, negative 1 times by 0, plus 0. Then 0 times by negative 1, plus 0. Then 0 times by 2, 0, plus 0 times by 0, 0, plus negative 1 times negative 1, positive 1. So it is equal to 0 plus 1, 1, 1 minus 2, negative 1. Then 0, 0, 0, so 0, 0, 0, and here is 1. And then compare with V2. Okay, so saya ada silap ni. Here. So 0 times by 2, 0. 1 times by 0, this one should be 0. Okay, so negative 2, 0 and 1. Okay, so compare with vector V2. Okay, so nampak 2, 0, negative 1. Cuma dia negatif dia terbalik. So this one is equal to negative 1 times by 2, 0 and negative 1. Okay, so since AV2 is equal to negative 1 times V2, so V2 is eigenvector for matrix A with eigenvalue lambda equal to negative 1. Okay, so ni kalau cara nak check lah. Kalau soalan bagi bentuk macam ni, cara nak check dia macam ni. Okay, so tapi sebenarnya soalan dia tak adalah suruh check macam tu. So biasa soalan dia suruh cari eigenvalues and the corresponding eigenvector. Okay, so first here, eigenspace. Okay, so A, B, N, N by N matrix with eigenvalue lambda, then the set of all eigenvectors of lambda together with the zero vector is a subspace of Rn. So this subspace is called eigenspace. Macam yang ni tadi, yang ke atas ni. Okay, so this one, V1 and V2 is the eigenvector for this matrix A kan. So ni jadi eigenvector. Okay, so this eigenvector together with the zero vector will produce an eigen space. Okay, so ni V1, V2 ni sekali dengan zero vector, dia akan membentuk satu eigen space. Tapi eigen space ni, untuk eigen space ni biasanya kita dalam soalan cuma perlu basis sajalah. So kita tak perlu pun nak cari eigen space, sebab eigen space susah sangat. So kita cuma cari eigen basis. Okay, so the basis for the eigen space. Okay, so to find the basis of the eigen space, so we need to have eigen vector. Okay. Okay, so before that, before you find the vector, so you need to find the eigen values. Okay, so to find the eigen values, so first we need to write down AV equal to lambda V as this one. AV equal to lambda IV. So this I actually is the identity. So this equation is equivalent to this one. Okay. So AIV minus AV. Okay, so yang ni AV kita pindah ke kanan. So become lambda IV minus AV, which is equal to zero vector. So this one will implies in bracket lambda I minus A times by vector V equal to zero vector. Or you can move this lambda IV to the left. So which is you will obtain AV minus lambda IV equal to zero vector. Okay, so this one A minus lambda IV equal to zero vector. So biasa kita pakai yang bawah ni lah. Tak kisahlah nak pakai atas pun boleh, tak ada masalah ni. Okay, so this A minus lambda I. So this one will produce matrix, and this one is vector. This one also same, dia akan jadi x, dan yang v ni adalah vector. Okay, so to find the eigenvalues. Okay, so we want the solution vector v which is equal to 0. Okay, so kita nak tadi eigen vector dia tak boleh sama dengan 0 vector. Okay, so syarat dia yang awal tadi, eigen vector tak boleh sama dengan 0 vector. Solution can be obtained if and only if A minus lambda I is a non-invertible matrix. Kalau dia invertible matrix, dia akan jadi A minus lambda I ni dia akan ada inverse. So bila dia ada inverse, so maksudnya kita boleh selesaikan V which is times by A minus lambda I inverse. Sebab yang ni saya bagi tahu A minus lambda I ni adalah matrix. Okay, so maksudnya kita boleh pindah sebelah, dia akan jadi inverse times by 0 vector. Itu kalau A minus lambda I tu invertible. So bila dia invertible, so kita boleh ada inverse, kita bawa pergi ke kanan times by 0 vector. So therefore we will obtain vector V which is equal to 0 vector. Okay, so apa-apa matrix dapat 0 vector, produce 0 vector lah. So yang ni tak akan menepati syarat yang atas tadi lah, sebab dia kata vector V ni, eigen vector, cannot be equal to 0 vector. So that's why A minus lambda I is non-invertible matrix. Okay, so to be non-invertible, okay, so maksudnya tak nak ada inverse. So hence the determinant of A minus lambda I must be equal to 0. So kalau dia sama dengan kosong, so maksudnya dia punya inverse dia tak wujud. Okay, so therefore if the inverse daripada ni, okay, so therefore from this, okay, from this concept, so we solve the determinant A minus lambda I equal to 0. Okay, so kita akan selesaikan lambda, and then we will obtain the eigen values. And this equation, we call it as characteristic equation for matrix A. Okay, so ni kita panggil sebagai characteristic equation for matrix A. Okay, so this characteristic equation will be used to find the eigen values. Okay, so example is one. Find all the eigen values for the following matrices. Okay, so we use determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to 0. Okay, so A is 2 by 2 matrix. So we have 3, 2, 4, 1 minus by lambda. So identity will follow this, the size of matrix A. So which is 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so determinant dia is equal to 0. Okay, so we have determinant of 3 minus lambda times by 1, so 3 minus lambda, and then 2 minus lambda times 0, so 2, then 4 minus lambda times 0 which is 4, then 1 minus lambda times 1, so become 1 minus lambda. Okay, so determinant of this matrix equal to 0. Okay, so determinant of this matrix 3 minus lambda times by 1 minus lambda minus by 4 times by 2 which is 8, so which is equal to 0. Okay, so nak selesaikan, so you need to expand this one. Okay, so 3 times by 1, 3, 3 times by negative lambda, negative 3 lambda, then negative lambda times by 1, negative lambda, negative lambda times by negative lambda, positive lambda square minus 8 which is equal to 0. Then from this one, we will obtain lambda, so minus 3 lambda minus lambda, so minus 4 lambda, and 3 minus by 8 is minus 5, so which is equal to 0. Then this one become quadratic, so you need to factorize. So lambda minus by 5 and lambda plus by 1 which is equal to 0. So then solve this equation. So we have lambda minus 5 equal to 0 and lambda plus 1 to 0, so which is lambda equal to 5 and lambda equal to negative 1. So eigenvalues is lambda equal to 5n negative 1. Okay. And then for the B. Okay, so we use determinant of A minus lambda I is equal to 0. Okay, so matrix A, which is 2, 0, 1, 0, 3, 0. So 1, 0, 2, minus by lambda. So the size of this identity will follow the size of matrix A. So which is 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1 block. So 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, which is equal to 0. Okay, so from here we will have lambda of 2 minus lambda times 1. So 2 minus lambda, and then 0 minus lambda times 0, 0, then 1 minus lambda times 0, 1, then 0 minus lambda times by 0, 0, then 3 minus lambda times by 1, so 3 minus lambda, then 0 minus lambda times by 0, which is 0, then 1 minus lambda times by 0, which is 1, then 0 minus lambda times by 0, 0, then 2 minus lambda times by 1, so 2 minus lambda, which is equal to 0. Okay, so and then, okay, so determinant. So you choose which row you want, row or column you want to use. Okay, so for me, so I use second row lah. Sebab kat sini ada banyak kosong, 1, 2. Okay, so you can use second row or second column. Okay, cofactor along the second row. So first 0, so 0 times by determinant of 0, 1, lambda, but 0, 0 times, so 0 lah, so tak payah nak kira. And then 3 minus lambda times with determinant of, so close with, so second row and so second column, which is 2 minus lambda, 1, 1 and 2 minus lambda, and then plus, okay, so before that, saya lupa lah. Okay, so negative 1 power of, so this one second row, second column, so 2 plus 2. So here is 3 minus lambda. Okay, so negative 1 kuasa ni saya lupa tertinggal, okay. Determinant of 2 minus lambda, 1, 1, 2 minus lambda. Okay, and then plus, okay, so for the last one, 0, so 0, tak payah kira lah, okay. So which is equal to 0. So negative 1 power of 4, which is positive 1. So we have 3 minus lambda times by determinant of this matrix, which is 2 minus lambda square, because 2 minus lambda times 2 minus lambda, so 2 minus lambda square, and then minus 1 times by 1, which is 1. So which is equal to 0. Then solve for lambda, which is for eigen values. So we have 3 minus lambda. So 2 minus lambda square become 4 minus 4 lambda, and then plus lambda square minus by 1. So which is equal to 0. So we have 3 minus lambda, and then this one 4 minus 1, which is 3. So lambda square minus 4 lambda plus by 3. So which is equal to 0. So 3 minus lambda, so lambda square minus 4 lambda plus 3. So factorize this one, so you will obtain lambda minus by 3 and lambda minus by 1, so which is equal to 0. Okay, so solve for lambda. So we have 3 minus lambda, which is equal to 0. Okay, so negative lambda equal to negative 3, so lambda equal to 3. And another one, which is lambda minus 3 is equal to 0. So lambda is equal to 3. So we have 2 eigenvalues same, okay. And then another one, lambda minus 1 equal to 0. So lambda is equal to 1. So eigenvalues, for matrix A are lambda equal to 3 and 1. Okay, so dia ada 3. Okay, so next we go to the eigenvalues of triangular matrix. Okay, so if A is an upper triangular, lower triangular or diagonal matrix, so then its eigenvalues are the values on its main diagonal. Okay, so dekat main diagonal je lah dia punya eigenvalues, tak payah susah-susah nak cari. So example this one, find all the eigenvalues for the following matrices. For the A, so matrix A, this one is the upper triangular matrix. So for the upper triangular matrix, so the eigenvalues is equal to the values on the main diagonal, which is negative 4, 0 and 8. Then B, so this matrix A is a diagonal matrix. So for the diagonal matrix, the eigenvalues is the values on the main diagonal, which is negative 2, 1, 5 and 0. Okay, so sama juga untuk lower triangular matrix. Okay. Okay, and then finding eigenvectors. So eigenvectors of matrix A corresponding to the eigenvalue lambda I are the non-zero vectors that satisfy the equation AV equal to lambda I V. Okay, so V ni tak ada, so kita kena cari. Okay, so therefore for every lambda I, we solve the equation A minus lambda I identity times by vector V equal to 0 vector to obtain the eigenvectors corresponding to lambda I. Then after we have this equation, so we take the augmented matrix and reduce into epsilon form. Okay. Okay, so use A minus lambda I, 0 vector, okay, augmented matrix, to reduce into rho epsilon form. So sini ada tertinggal sikit kat sini, okay. So to reduce into rho epsilon form, which contains at least 1 0 rho. Okay, so the basis. Okay, so nanti dah dapat 0 rho, so kita akan dapat eigen vector dia. And then the basis for the solution set form a basis for the eigenspace of A corresponding to lambda I. So lepas pakai vector, kita akan ambil basis dia untuk membentuk satu basis untuk eigenspace. Okay, so from this theorem tunjukkan untuk cari eigenvalues. Okay, so the eigenvalues of A are the values of lambda such that determinant of A minus lambda I, which is equal to 0. And the eigenvectors corresponding to lambda, to each eigenvalue lambda, are the non-trivial solutions for the homogeneous system of A minus lambda I vector V equal to 0 vector. Okay, so kita tengok contoh kat sini. Okay, so find all the eigenvalues and corresponding eigenvectors for the following matrix. Okay, so this matrix daripada yang atas tadi, 2 0 1 0 3 0 1 0 2. Okay, so daripada yang sini ni, okay, so from this one, B, we already found the eigenvalues, which is 3, 3, 1. Okay. Dan dapat eigenvalues dia tadi, 3, 3, 1, 3. Okay, so for each eigenvalue lambda, we will find the corresponding eigenvectors such that this one, so A minus lambda I, V equal to 0 vector. Okay, so from this formula, so you will obtain 2 minus lambda a matrix times a vector V, which is equal to 0 vector. So macam mana nak dapat yang 2 tolak lambda apa benda tu? So daripada sinilah, so A minus lambda I. Okay, so from this one, so you will have 2 0 1 0 3 0, so 1 0 2, minus by lambda I is 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, so it is equal to 2 minus lambda, so 0 minus 0, so 1 minus 0 is 1, then 0 minus lambda times 0, 0, 3 minus lambda times 1, so 3 minus lambda, and then 0 minus 0 becomes 0, and here also same, so become 1, 0, 2 minus lambda. So korang masukkan equation ni, nanti korang akan dapat matrix yang ni. Okay. Okay, so for lambda equal to 3, okay, so eigenvalue is 3. So from the augmented matrix, okay, so for lambda equal to 3, so we will have A minus, so this lambda substitute with 3. So A minus 3 times identity times by vector V is equal to 0 vector. Okay, so nanti korang kembangkan, korang akan dapat bentuk macam ni lah. So 2 minus 3, 3 minus 3 and 2 minus 3. And then from this matrix, form the augmented matrix and reduce into row echelon form. Okay, so 2 minus 3, 0, 1, 0, 3 minus 3, 0, 1, 0, 2 minus 3. And here is 0, 0, 0. Okay, so here, I take here, put here. So 2 minus 3, negative 1, 0, 1, 0, 3 minus 3 is 0, 0, and then 1, 0, and then 2 minus 3 is negative 1. So tadi kat atas tadi at least 0 vector kan. Okay, so kita dah ada satu 0 row. So at least 1 0 row. Okay, so kita dah ada. So on the left kita kena jadikan dia betul lah. So this one become leading one row echelon form kan. So here leading one. So therefore row 1 multiply with negative and put back at row number 1. So we have 1 0 negative 1. And then make it this one become 0. Okay, so to make it this 0, so 1 minus 1, so row 3 minus row 1, and put back at row number 3. So therefore we have 1, 0, negative 1. Okay, so this is 0, and here also 0. Okay, so now after we obtain the the row echelon form, okay, so we use back substitution. So we obtain here V1. Okay, so this one is the leading one for V1. Here V2 and here V3. So for the V2 there is no leading one. For V3 also there is no leading one. So therefore V2 and V3 is are free variable. Okay, so therefore we have V1 minus V3 which is equal to 0. So V1 equal to V3. So V2 and V3 is lead variable. Okay, so for the free variable, so we let V2 equal to T and V3 is equal to R. So therefore V1 is also is equal to R. Okay, so therefore we have the eigenvector. Eigenvectors for lambda is equal to 3 is vector V, which is equal to V1, which is R, V2 which is T, and V3 which is R. Okay, so with T and R element in real number. Okay, so with the condition T is not equal to 0 and R also not equal to 0. Or you can write down in term of this one. So R, okay, so for the R which is 1, 0, 1 plus 0, 1, 0. So kita keluarkan untuk yang R dekat sini, untuk yang T dekat sini. So untuk yang R, R dekat atas dengan bawah dia yang ada. So atas dengan bawah ni 1, 1. So tengah-tengah ni kosong lah. And then for the T, we only have at the middle. So at the middle is 1 and the rest is 0. Okay, so condition dia T, R element in real number, and T is not equal to 0 and R also not equal to 0. Okay, so this one for the eigenvalues lambda equal to 3. Okay, so hilang pula. Okay, so saya salah tadi, sepatutnya saya okay, dia pelik sikit lah saya punya tab ni. Tak apalah, korang dah tengok kan, nanti reverse lah balik. Okay, so for the lambda equal to 1 next. Okay, so by using the same thing, so lambda now already 1. So lambda equal to 1, so we have here A minus by 1 times by identity times by vector V is equal to 0 vector. And then form the augmented matrix. and reduce into rho epsilon form. Okay, so 2 minus by lambda, 0, 1, 0, 3 minus by lambda, 0, 1, 0, 2 minus by lambda. So lambda is 1. Okay, 0, 0, 0. Okay, so 2 minus 1 is 1, 0, 0, 3 minus 1 is 2, 2 minus 1 is 1. Okay, and then reduce into rho epsilon form. So this one already leading 1. So kat sini dah leading 1. So therefore we make it this one become 0. So to make it this one become 0, rho 3 minus rho 1 and put back at rho number 3. So we have this one 0 rho, okay? And then after that make it this one become leading 1. So to make it this one leading 1, so we use 1 over 2 times by rho 2 and put back at rho number 2. Okay, so we have this form. Okay, so this one here for V1, V2 and V3. Okay, so V1 we have the leading 1 here, V2 leading 1 here. For V3 there is no leading 1. So therefore V3 is the free variable. Okay, so before that use back substitution to obtain V1 plus 0 V2, so 0, plus 1 V3. So V3 is equal to 0. Then from the second row, 0 V1 plus 1 V2, V2 plus 0 V3 is equal to 0. So therefore V2 is equal to 0. And from this one implies V1 equal to negative V3. And just now V3 is free variable. So therefore we let V3 is equal to S. Okay, tak kisahlah R ke T ke S. Okay. Okay, so from this one V3 equal to S and V2 is equal to 0 and V1 is equal to negative S. So therefore the eigenvector for lambda equal to 0 is V, which is equal to, okay, so V1 negative S, 0 S, with S element in real number with the condition S not equal to 0. Or you can write down in term of this one, S outside and here he is negative 1, 0, 1. Okay, so with the condition S element in R and S cannot equal to 0. Okay, so before that saya tertinggal. So yang atas ni tadi, okay, so okay, saya tulis semula yang atas ni. Okay, so this one is the eigenvector for lambda equal to 3. Okay, so from this one the basis for eigen space for lambda equal to 3 is 1 0 1 and 0 1 0. Okay, so 1 0 1 and 0 1 0, this one will form a eigen space for matrix A. Okay, and the dimension for this eigen space is 2. Okay, so dimension dia 2 lah sebab dia ada 2 basis. Okay, okay, so 1 0 1 and 0 1 0, this one will form a basis for eigen space for lambda equal to 3. Okay, so if for lambda equal to 1, so this is the eigen vector. So we have negative 1. So this negative 1, 0, 1 will form a basis for the eigenspace of matrix A. Okay. So the basis for eigenspace for lambda equal to 1 is negative 1, 0, 1 with dimension of the eigen is 1. Okay, bukan with lah, tak payah with lah, titik. And the dimension of the eigen space is 1. Okay, Okay, so next we go to the eigenvalues of the power matrix, of the inverse of a matrix, and of the transpose of a matrix. Okay, so matrix A itu kita akan ada A power of K, so A power of 2, power of 3, and power of 5. Okay, and then we also have the inverse of matrix A, and also we have the transpose of matrix A. Okay, so for each of this matrix, okay, so we can find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Okay, so for the power of A, okay, so power of matrix A, okay, so for A power of K, with K is a positive integer, so the eigenvalue is lambda K. Okay, so before that, let A be an n by n matrix with the eigenvalue lambda and corresponding eigenvector V. Okay, so maksudnya matrix A ni dia ada, dah ada eigenvalues dengan eigenvector dia ni. Okay, so for A power of K, okay, so where K is a positive integer, so the eigenvalue of A power of K we can obtain by using lambda power of K, and also the corresponding eigenvector is V. So maksudnya kita tak usik lah, eigenvector dia akan sama dengan yang original. Okay, and then for the transpose matrix AT, so dia punya eigenvalue doesn't change, but for the eigenvector, so we need to find using AT minus lambda I V equal to 0 vector. So maksudnya samalah dengan cara yang atas tadi tu. Alamak. Okay, so dia sama dengan cara yang ni. Okay, so sama dengan cara yang ni, cuma dekat A ni dia akan ubah kepada A transpose. So nanti kalau dia keluar soalan macam tu, so korang kena ikut step yang sama yang ni, okay? And then for the inverse, okay, so if A is an invertible matrix, okay, so therefore the eigenvalue for A inverse we can search by using 1 divided by lambda, and the eigenvector doesn't change. Okay, eigenvector dia sama. Okay, eigenvector yang berbeza hanya pada dekat A transpose. So untuk A transpose ni dia punya eigenvector kena cari semula. Okay. Okay, so example here. Given matrix A is equal to 2 0 0 3 0 1 0 2, has eigenvalues 3 1 3, and corresponding eigenvectors are for lambda equal to 1, so we have this one, and for lambda equal to 3, we have this one. Okay, so tadi dah buat dah tadi dekat atas kan. So tadi saya ambil contoh yang atas tadi tu. Okay, then find the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors for A power of 3. Okay, so eigenvalues dia untuk A power of 3, okay, so we have lambda equal to 3 power of 3 and 1 power of 3 and 3 power of 3, so which is equal to 27, 1 and 27. And for the eigenvector, okay, so dia akan sama dengan yang ni. Okay, so nanti tulislah, so eigenvector dia sama. Okay, so untuk example ni saya lupa nak buat space dia, saya buat bawah ni lah. Okay, untuk yang A, so eigenvector dia for lambda equal to 23, so eigenvector dia, okay, so this one will be equal to the eigenvector for lambda equal to 3. Okay, so yang tu bukan 23, 27. Okay, so lambda equal to 27, so the eigenvector is, okay, so the eigenvector will be equivalent to the eigenvector for lambda equal to 3. Sebab 27 ni terhasil daripada yang lambda sama dengan 3. So the eigenvector is equal to RTR. Okay, so with RT is element in real number, with R cannot equal to 0 and T cannot equal to 0, and then for lambda is equal to 1, So the eigenvector, it is equivalent to the eigenvector for lambda equal to 1. So which is negative R, 0, R. R element in real number with the condition R cannot equal to 0. Okay. And then for the B, find the eigenvalues for A transpose. So for the A transpose, eigenvalues dia tak berubah sama. So which is 3, 3, 1. Okay. Or 3, 1, 3. Okay. And then for the eigenvalues for A inverse, so eigenvalues dia is equal to 1 over and 1 over 1 and 1 over 3. Okay, so which is equal to 1 over 3, 1 and 1 over 3. So untuk A inverse, eigenvector dia akan sama, corresponding. Okay, and then for A transpose, the eigenvector we need to find again. So mudah, okay? So nanti korang bolehlah try cari, okay? Okay, so next, eigenvalues and invertibility of a matrix. Okay, so a square matrix A is invertible, which is non-singular, if and only if lambda equal to 0 is not one of the eigenvalues of A. Okay, so kalau dia punya eigenvalues tu tak termasuk kosong, so maksudnya matrix A ni invertible. Tapi kalau eigenvalues dia ada kosong, so matrix A ni non-invertible lah. Okay, so determine whether the following matrices are invertible or not. Okay, so first we need to find the eigenvalues lah. Okay, so for the A, find the eigenvalues. So we have 1 minus lambda 0, 0. So here 1, 0 minus, so minus lambda 1. And here 1, 0, 2 minus lambda. Determinant is equal to 0. Okay, so siapa yang dah mahir nanti dia akan senanglah nak buat yang ni. So I use cofactor expansion along the first row. Okay, so along row 1, so we have negative 1 power of row 1 column 1, so 1 plus 1 times by 1 minus lambda times by determinant of negative lambda 1, 0, 2 minus lambda, so which is equal to 0. So negative 1 power of 2, positive 1, so we have 1 minus lambda times by negative lambda times by 2 minus lambda minus by 1 times 0 is 0, so it's equal to 0. And then so we have here 1 minus lambda in bracket negative lambda times by 2 minus lambda, which is equal to 0. Okay, so we have 1 minus lambda, so here multiplication, here also multiplication, so I can write down 1 minus lambda times by negative lambda and then 2 minus by lambda, which is equal to 0. Okay, so saya selesaikan. So you will obtain 1 minus lambda equal to 0. Okay, so lambda is equal to 1. And then negative lambda is equal to 0. This 1 lambda is equal to 0. And then 2 minus lambda is equal to 0. So lambda equal to 2. Okay, so since there is 0 eigenvalues, okay, so 0 eigenvalues, so which is lambda equal to 0. So matrix A is not invertible. Okay, so maksudnya matrix A tak invertible. Okay, so sebab ada 0 eigenvalues. Okay, so yang B, so find the eigenvalues for this matrix A. Okay, so the determinant of 1 minus lambda 0, 0, 1, 1 minus lambda 1, 1, 0, 2 minus lambda, which is equal to 0. Okay, so I use the row 1. So we have 1 minus, okay, so before that negative 1. So negative 1 power of 1 plus 1 times by 1 minus lambda, okay, times by determinant of 1 minus lambda 1 0 2 minus lambda, which is equal to 0. Yang kedua ketiga ni tak payahlah sebab dia kosong, kosong. Okay, so we have 1 negative 1 power of 2, which is 1. So we have 1 minus lambda, and then 1 minus lambda times by 2 minus lambda minus by 1 times 0, which is 0. So equal to 0. So we have here 1 minus lambda and 1 minus lambda times by 2 minus lambda, so equal to 0. Okay, so from this one, so you can obtain the eigenvalues, which is 1 minus lambda equal to 0. So we have the first eigenvalues, which is lambda equal to 1. And then same, 1 minus lambda equal to 0. So second eigenvalues, which is 1. And then 2 minus lambda equal to 0. And third eigenvalues, which is equal to 2. Okay, so since, okay, so since none of the eigenvalues is 0, so matrix A is invertible. Okay, okay, so yang ni untuk invertible. Okay, so that's all for our lesson today. So see you later. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.